Hello friends, welcome to my channel Technical Education to Solve Technical Problems. In this video we are setting the timing on John Deere 6068 6 cylinder engine without John Deere timing tool. When you see the figure in the manual, you will see that from the center of the camshaft gear, the timing mark and the crankshaft center are in single line. In manual it's written that with JD254 timing tool resting on nose of crankshaft and center of camshaft, turn camshaft until mark A on camshaft gear aligns with the timing tool. This is the timing tool, but we are not going to use it as we have understood the principle of this tool. The second thing to be noted during the timing setting is the timing marks on the injection pump gear. These are the different times of injection pump gear timing marks. Our pump is standard 9 6 cylinder engine, as 6 is the timing mark for our John Deere 6068 engine, as we have installed the standard 9 6 cylinder pump on that. There you can see the procedure is repeated on the fuel pump gear, the center of the crankshaft, the timing mark and the center of the gear of fuel pump are in line. That is the basic rule of setting the timing on John Deere 6068 or in John Deere engine. Use the timing mark corresponding to the number of cylinders the engine has that is being timed. So our engine is John Deere 6068 and it has 6 cylinders with a timing with a fuel pump standard 9. Bring the number 1 cylinder and the number 6 cylinder on the top TDC, top dead center of compression stroke. Also insert 2 push rods at number 6 cylinder. Confirm that with moving your camshaft gear, your push rods are moving up and down. Now enhance the timing mark on the fuel pump, because we have 3 marks on the fuel pump, S6, L6 and 4. Now twist the wire like that to make the timing tool with the help of this wire. Now as you have seen in the beginning of the video, in the manual of John Deere, the timing gear of the fuel pump, the timing mark on this gear and the center of the crankshaft should be in line. Similarly, the timing mark on the camshaft gear, its center and the crankshaft center should be in line for setting the timing. Now that is the timing mark for the camshaft gear. The center of the camshaft gear, the timing mark and the crankshaft center is in line with the help of this tool. If you look closely, we have placed the S6 mark under our timing line. These are the 2 points S6 and 4, and that is the third point L6. As mentioned in the manual, the same gear will be used on different pumps. You have to select your mark according to your fuel pump. Now cross check the timing of your camshaft with the help of the push rods. When your push rods are in the valve overlap condition, the valve overlap is the period during engine operation when both intake and exhaust valves are open at the same time. When you move your camshaft gear back and forth, both your intake and exhaust valve push rods will move up and down almost at same time. With the help of this simple formula, you can check the valve timing of your engine with the help of this camshaft gear. When both your timing gears are installed perfectly, insert the idler gear the idle gear, which is connecting the crankshaft with your fuel pump and the camshaft gear. This is the idler gear. As you have seen in the page of the manual I have shown you in the beginning of the video, don't forget to place the numbering in opposite direction of the engine. This will increase the lubrication of the idler gear. You can see the number on the idler gear is in the opposite direction of the engine. Be careful not to move your fuel pump gear or the camshaft gear. After inserting the idle gear, again recheck and confirm both the camshaft gear and the fuel pump gear are in their place and their timing marks are not disturbed during the installation of idle gear. Here you can see the mark is at its place. Repeat the process for the fuel pump gear and confirm it with the help of this handmade tool. If your timing is okay, your engine will start very smoothly and there will be no smoke. Here you can see we have started the engine after completion of assembling. The engine is running smoothly without smoke. It means that our fuel pump gear and the camshaft gear are installed perfectly. The complete playlist of the videos of overhauling of John Deere 6068 engine are available at the end of this video. Here you can see no smoke on the turbo. Thanks for watching the video. Subscribe the channel for more videos like that. Whenever you are starting the engine after overhauling, don't forget to install a mechanical gauge for monitoring the oil pressure in the engine.